the angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh.
Dwelt
among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. We beseech you, Lord, pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion may we be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Christ our Lord. Mercy on me, O God, for people assail me. They fight me all day long and oppress me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Welcome to Mass today on Monday of the fifth week of Lent, the beginning of Passion Tide, when we turn our faces towards the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. We offer this Mass for our parish as we keep these last days of preparation for the Paschal Festival. To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind and confess our sins. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whose wondrous grace we are enriched with every blessing, grant us so to pass from former ways to newness of life, that we may be made ready for the glory of the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Daniel. Susanna was condemned to death by the whole assembly. She cried out as loud as she could, "Eternal God, you know all secrets and everything before it happens. You know that they have given false evidence against me. And now have I to die? Innocent as I am of everything their malice has invented against me." The Lord heard her cry, and as she was being led away to die, he roused the Holy Spirit residing in a young boy named Daniel, who began to shout, I am innocent of this woman's death. At which all the people turned to him and asked, What do you mean by these words? Standing in the middle of the crowd, he replied, Are you so stupid, sons of Israel, as to condemn a daughter of Israel unheard and without troubling to find out the truth? Go back to the scene of the trial. These men have given false evidence against her. All the people hurried back, and the elders said to Daniel, Come and sit with us and tell us what you mean. Since God has given you the gifts that elders have. Daniel said, Keep the men well apart from each other, for I want to question them. When the men had been separated, Daniel had one of them brought to him. You have grown old in wickedness, he said, and now the sins of your earlier days have overtaken you. You, with your unjust judgments, your condemnations of the innocent, your acquittal of guilty men, when the Lord has said, You must not put the innocent and the just to death. Now then, since you saw her so clearly, tell me what tree you saw them lying under. He replied, Under a mastic tree. Daniel said, True enough. Your lie recoils on your own head. The angel of God has already received your sentence from him and will slash you in half. He dismissed the man, ordered the other to be brought, and said to him, Spawn of Canaan, not of Judah, beauty has seduced you, lust has led your heart astray. This is how you have been behaving with the daughters of Israel, and they were too frightened to resist. But here is a daughter of Judah who could not stomach your wickedness. Now then, tell me what tree you surprised them under. He replied, Under a holm oak. Daniel said, True enough. Your lie recoils on your own head. The angel of God is waiting with a sword to drive home and split you and destroy the pair of you. Then the whole assembly shouted, Blessing God, the Savior of those who trust in him. And they turned on the two elders whom Daniel had convicted of false evidence out of their own mouths, as prescribed in the law of Moses. They sentenced them to the same punishment as they had intended to inflict on their neighbor. They were put to death. The life of an innocent woman was spared that day. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm, If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear.
If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. If I should walk in the valley guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear.
My heart and my lips, that I may worthily proclaim your holy gospel. Glory to you, O Christ, you are the Word of God. Glory to you, O Christ, you are the Word of God. Now is the favourable time, this is the day of salvation. Glory to you, O Christ, you are the Word of God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. At daybreak he appeared in the temple again, and as all the people came to him, he sat down and began to teach them. The scribes and Pharisees brought a woman along who had been caught committing adultery, and making her stand there in full view of everybody, they said to Jesus, "Master, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery, and Moses has ordered us in the law to condemn women like this to death by stoning. What have you to say?" They asked him this as a test, looking for something to use against him. But Jesus bent down and started writing on the ground with his finger. As they persisted with their question, he looked up and said, "If there is one of you who has not sinned, let him be the first to throw a stone at her." Then he bent down and wrote on the ground again. When they heard this, they went away, one by one, beginning with the eldest, until Jesus was left alone with the woman who remained standing there. He looked up and said, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she replied. "Neither do I condemn you," said Jesus. "Go away and don't sin any more." Soul of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
In the power of the Spirit and the union with Christ, let us pray now to the Father. For the church, especially for the church in this diocese, for Michael, its bishop, and for Paul, our bishop. Those being prepared for baptism at Easter, and for clergy preparing to renew their priestly and diaconal vows. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the world, for peace and justice, for honesty and integrity in the leaders of the nations and in those who represent us in government, national and local, and for those places of conflict, and for all who are seeking to bring aid to the refugee and the hungry. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For family and friends, for three members of our congregation who have a birthday today, and for those we know to be in need, especially for Joan, Anne, Chris, Claire, Meg, Margaret, Sue, Julie, Pauline, Roy, David, Jane, Julia, Derek, Beryl, Alfie, Yvonne, Ron, Grace, Richard, Jackie, Gareth, Derek, and Liz, and for those who have no one to pray for them, who are sick in mind, body, or spirit, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the repose of the souls of the faithful departed, especially on the anniversary of her passing, Anne Angelique Rudman. And remembering those who died recently, Michael, Anthony Hain, priest, Brian Parry, priest, John Scannell. Praying for those who mourn their passing, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And for our own personal needs and intentions. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Father, hear the prayers we make in the name of your Son, our Saviour and our Redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and this wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself and shared in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sinfulness. Pray, dear friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that preparing to celebrate the holy mysteries, we may bring before you as the fruit of bodily penance a joyful purity of heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty. Since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed, and the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Christ is the bread of life. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come in glory. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption as we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. We bring before you the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation, and we thank you for counting us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, of John the Evangelist, the beloved disciple, our patron, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of that peace. Peace be with you. Peace you get. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Very polite. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world, free us by this your most holy body and blood from all our sins and from every evil. Keep us always faithful to your commandments, and never let us be parted from. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Corpus Christi me custodiat in vitam aeternam. Amen. Sanguinis Christi, me custodiat in vitam aeternam. Amen. Let us pray. Strengthened by the blessing of your sacraments, we pray, O Lord, that through them we may constantly be cleansed of our faults, and by following Christ hasten our steps upward toward you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
May Christ crucified draw you to himself, to find in him a sure ground for faith, a firm support for hope, and the assurance of your sins forgiven. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go now in the peace of Christ.